protectors of the Sunnah. Sunnah Baba, protector of the Sunnah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. ويص الفرس ركعة من يصل الساتد في سورة العنكبوت. ألف لام ميم. أحسب الناس أن يدركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. أحسب الناس. The people what they believe. Some people we believe من الله سبحانه وتعالى. أحسب الناس they think they are believe in الله محمد. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and believe in the Quran. There is no fitna, trials, tribulation, hardship. Just the ayah, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَنْ يُتْرَكُوا أَنْ يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ قَبْلَهُمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. The ayah after that, to distinguish who's the truthful person and who's the not. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أعظم فتنة The most hardship, trials, and tribulation, fitnat al-Dajjal, al-Masih al-Dajjal, Antichrist. And what is it? Do you know Dajjal in your language? What the Dajjal? Antichrist?
Did you say Dajjal?
Dajjal? Okay. Everybody, I think everybody says Dajjal. Dajjal, we know Dajjal. Of course, as I said yesterday, not in details. Not the days we love, but one of the hadith of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم من علامات القيامة, one of the signs of the day of judgment, لا يذكر الدجال على المنابر. الدجال in the minbar when the imam make the khutbah للجمعة, barely to somebody speak about الدجال, the antichrist, الدجال. Didn't ask a question yesterday, this is a question I asked. Some people came today. When the last time you heard khutbah للجمعة, About the Dajjal, Antichrist, the Imam, speak about the Dajjal.
Long time.
See, that and that's actually Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that. See, barely somebody here. In fact, as I just yesterday we spoke, suddenly the youth start to call me, especially my son, I told him, Umar, about Dajjal, and that's good. But not only that, we are adults. We have to tell our kids about the Dajjal. Why? Why? Because the Dajjal make the Muslims make them kafir easy. Because he bring in all that. More, the majority of the people, the majority running about money. By the way, it's good to be rich. To do it for the masjid too. But good to be. But some people, they forget even salah. Forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the money. And the Dajjal bring all kinds of treasures. In fact, the Dajjal, the Antichrist, it would till the earth bring all the treasures from the earth. The treasure comes out. Treasures. Kunuz. Come. And the one run after the dunya. Of course. But of course, in summary, of course, we're not doing too much, inshallah. But the Dajjal, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in fact, Ibn Sayyad, somebody, kids in Medina, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he saw the description of Dajjal. Not only that, imagine every salah in tashahud, the end of the tashahud, say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min fitnat al-Masih al-Dajjal. One of the dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adab al-qabr wa fitnat al-Masih al-Dajjal. The tries of al-Masih al-Dajjal, Antichrist. That is Rasulullah. And he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, also in the hadith, كل الأنبياء, all the prophets, حذروا أمتهم من الدجال. All the prophets told about الدجال, Antichrist. Also in Arabic language, الدجال, the one he's a liar, الكذاب, bring beautiful things and cover it, but when you know what's going on inside, that's a كذب. Bring something, you believe it. In fact, Many of the signs Rasulullah told us about Dajjal is appear. For example, one of the signs of the Day of Judgment, when Dajjal coming, barely for the people to come for Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Isha. How many people Salat al-Isha and al-Fajr? Type, how many people Salat al-Jum'ah? I found out actually, even Jum'ah, even in Martyrs Beach County, many Muslims, but oh, they told me actually, we cannot come because we have to work. That's one of the sign of the Day of Judgment. Why? Salat al-Jum'ah for men is obligatory. You have to, you have no choice. Even in school, by the way. Even in school, you have, but it's haram, any work in the time for men. For Salat al-Jum'ah, in the time of Salat al-Jum'ah. But Rasulullah told us that. My point, now, because Dajjal come only when he come, aware from where, what kind of nationality of the Dajjal?
Iran.
Iran. But Iran, there's a Muslims in Iran.
Yeah, between Iran and Iraq.
Asbahan. Asbahan. But Asbahan, by the way, 99% Jews.
Yeah, and the village that he wants, the village called it Yehuda.
Oh, أنت إيراني كنت مش عارف كده أنا.
نعم،
okay. My point, yes, he comes from that area, and 70,000 of them actually, by the way, groups, not the person, they will come with the Dajjal. Why? Now the Jews actually control the whole world, especially our United States of America, controlled by the Jews. You are American? I'm a citizen, but we study actually to get the citizenship. We study the city, but actually it's 100% control the Jews, the Congress, the senators, everyone the Jews, and that's one of the signs of the judgment. In fact, the great banks, every country controlled by them. My point, Rasulullah told us about that. But you can, of course, the hadith actually. Mecca and Medina, Dajjal will never enter. Some people actually, they also Jabal al-Tur, where Musa alayhi salam in the Sinai area. You cannot enter that area, but it's not authentic hadith 100%. And also Al-Quds, Jerusalem. But Musa alayhi salam, he come, Isa alayhi salam, he come, he pray inside the Masjid al-Aqsa. And he killed Dajjal. But in summary, inshallah, of course, in summary, of course, he killed only one person, Muslim, in front of the people. And first, he killed a person, of course, his job, sihr, magic. Actually, all the Arab, the Muslim leaders, all the, not Arab, all the Muslim leaders controlled by Dajjal. But how? There is not single one Muslim country give something for their people. Dictatorship 100%. We'll speak about it in more details that. But my point, Quds, Dajjal, he will come, the Antichrist, Dajjal will come to Mecca and Medina, he's not going to enter that area. Don't enter that area. And of course, how he look like, it come hour. You have one, the left one eye. Some hadith actually right eye will be like عِنَبَ عِنَبَ that means grape, and some people right. But regardless, he'll come, he have one eye only. One eye or good hour. And of course, in summary, as I said, so this is the question I give my son and a lot of kids. Could speak to my son about this Dajjal? So I think to go actually with the question, whoever I hear the question, of course you have more questions, so I will share it together inshallah. Okay, okay. Of course he bring nar and jannah. He bring a fire and a paradise. And Rasulullah taught us, when he go invited to the jannah, refuse, go to the nar. Go to his fire. His fire is a Jannah, and Jannah is a hellfire. May Allah protect us from that. Okay. Of course, I mentioned yesterday, now, how when he come out to the earth, as I mentioned yesterday, say 40 days. And one day يوم بسنة one day equal one year ويوم بشهر one day one month ويوم بأسبوع one day equal one week وسائر أيام. So then after that normal days 40 days but كالريح just like a wind fast one country that means the whole world except مكة and Medina. Imagine that how much the airplanes now when I went in France actually to come to United States, come to America normally you go to France takes 12 hours right
7 hours
plus tax yeah but now this new airplanes 1 hour and 35 minutes be here and even the airplanes now fighting the Skyhawk and this and that fast too and I heard actually the Congress now will have a new airplane it's very very extremely fast but Allah knows best Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of course many people bringing Dajjal that my point in Hadith Rasul 40 days 1 year 1 month 1 week one meet and that's the key in 1 year you have to pray 5 times same 1 month still five times وَدُلُوا لَهُمْ قَدْرًا make the estimated of the time in that time may Allah protect us from that Ameen but now the kids actually asked أَيْنَ يَعِيشُ where he live now we cannot find it where he live huh? Where he live in Dajjal here عبد الحق المغرب
no Palestine no, they said
you know, they come to Palestine
yeah, but Palestine.
Okay, but now where is Dajjal is? Yes, he will come to Palestine. Yes, he will come to Palestine. But before Palestine, come to Morocco. But where exactly? The answer, suppose, no idea. Allah knows best. Because some people do it in Yemen, some people do it in Iran. Allah knows best. Until now, we don't have authentic hadith or ayah that Dajjal, he will come in that time. Where, inshallah. That's exactly, I don't know. Okay, think about this. Also, of course, as I mentioned, by the fitna, by the way, he bring people, actually, with his magic, bring the father and the mother for the kids, the mom and the dad. And the father make them speak, and the mom speak, especially the mom, اتبعوا. Go and follow him. Follow him, he's the right one. How much fit that? How much we love our parents. Especially if they die, our heart broke, especially the mom. Especially the mom, you don't know. My mom died actually, last time, my father first. When my mom died, my heart stopped. How much we love that. But the mom will come, go and follow him. That we have, that's why. We have to أعوذ بالله نعوذ من فتنة المسيح الدجال in Salah, every Salah. May Allah protect us from that. Ameen, Ya Rabbi, Ameen. Of course, and of course, ما بين آدم إلى قيام الساعة أمر أكبر فتنة from Adam عليه السلام until the last person will die in this earth about the Dajjal and the Dajjal. Of course, I have a big topic about that, but it's not now, inshallah. By the way, Dajjal, by the way, now you see the preparation of Dajjal. Mecca and Medina, actually Saudi Arabia in general, there's absolutely no liquor, no dancing, no singers, no. Everything now, you go to Saudi Arabia, you'll find it. Where the Rasulullah says, liquors, drugs, dancing, singers. Bars publicly with no problem with that. In fact, used to be have a ministry of Dawah. There's no more. That means a free country now. That's one of the signs of the judgment. Another thing I mentioned that there's a masajid, one of the signs. People love masajid. One masjid actually in Texas costs more than $5 million 300 million. Yeah, that's the one I mean, I was part of that. Imagine when I went to the Salah, to that masjid actually, before I came here, I went to the masjid there. Salat al-Fajr, three people. Salat al-Isha, five people. I took the Jum'ah that day, maybe 25% of the people. But cost millions of dollars. How much is that masjid?
300 million.
300 million a masjid. How many people go to that masjid?
We're going to finish it in next year.
That's the very scary part. If the masjid, beautiful masjid, and there's barely for the people to come, that's another problem. Also, we have to teach our kids, actually, minimum, about the Dajjal, and we have to teach our kids at least فوادح الحمد لله الذي سورة الكهف. The beginning of سورة الكهف, 10 آيات سورة الكهف, at least for the kids. It's very, very important. And very important for us also to recite it. If we're, you know, Zal Haditha was Friday, but you can bring any time, by the way. Any time, you can, you know, for example, last week, normally in a car when I'm busy. But it's good to read it from the Quran. If I'm busy, when I'm driving, I just recite. But it's good to read from the Quran, And it's good to have with your family and recite Surah Al-Kahf together. Of course, there is some Arab, you know, cannot be recited. Listen at least for Surah Al-Kahf and step by step recite, memorize, or understand the last 10 days from Surah Al-Kahf. I finish here because I have to speak more and more. I have prepared myself a lot. But any question? Al-Dajjal, Antichrist, God. It's very, very bad things. You have to teach your brother?
No, it's my cousin.
And cousin. Teach him about Dajjal. Any question? Yes.
Just I add something.
Add.
Said, to be protected from the Dajjal, Antichrist, you have like 11 ayahs, the last 11 ayahs of the Surah Al-Kahf.
No, there's one hadith in the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf and some of the end of Surah Al-Kahf. It's most likely the more authentic hadith, the last 10 days, 10 ayat from Surah Al-Kahf.
The first one.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, more? Wallahi, actually, have a good idea. A brother, Muhammad, the brother Abu Yusuf, he asked once, I don't know, let's think about this. Let me just hang up this before. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.